walked with a cane and had to for 2.5 years. I had a back and neck injury from motorsports, and I've got to tell you, if you're out there right now and you walk with a cane, there is a certain level of frustration that comes from that lack of mobility. That by itself is frustrating. The second thing is, when you walk with a cane, if you drop anything, all of a sudden, you're at the mercy of having to ask for help. Already, my own ego and my own feelings of self-independence were challenged by having to walk with a walking stick. But if I dropped something, then I would have to say to my wife, can you pick that up? That hurt. I've never seen a product that does this. I have seen grabbers, but when you're walking with a cane, you already have one hand that's occupied. You're not going to occupy the other one with the grabber. I want to introduce you to a friend. This is Dan Byrne.
Dan,
welcome.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
This is only the second time this product has ever been presented, and I've been waiting for it to come into our show. He's the co-developer, the co-inventor of the product. It is all about taking your cane, and if you drop something, there's a little button right here. You push it with your thumb, and out of the bottom pops a grabber. And then you have this wonderful little hinge here that allows you to pick things up, and even big things. Dropping something when you have a walking stick or a cane is a nightmare.
It's a nightmare. It's basically the longest 3 feet you're gonna ever have.
Yes.
And the reason being, if you bend over, what do you risk? You risk hurting yourself, you risk falling. Well, you know what? Now we have the answer.
Dan, you made a comment to me, and you made this a few days ago, and you mentioned it to me this morning. That 3 feet might as well be 3 miles. Look at this. Just do it again. Just do this again.
If you have a cane and you start your day like this, your day is starting terrible.
Yes.
Because now you're wondering to yourself, how am I going to get it? Do I have a second toothbrush? Well, you know what? Now we have the answer. And you know what? We can do many things with it. That's just the start of your day. I mean, how about when you're at the bank in the afternoon? Do you want to ask the teller for a second pen? No, because you're embarrassed that you can't bend over and pick it up. Well, you know what? We have that answer right here.
And the word handicapped is not in my vocabulary. It's handicapable. And I was a raving lunatic in my early 30s with my back injury and having to walk with a cane. And I didn't ever want to be rude, but I didn't want your help. Right. I wanted to do it myself because already my independence had been challenged. I've been fortunate. I've had neck surgery and back surgery. I feel great now. But there's a lot of you out there that walk with a walking stick or a cane every single day of your life. And you know the frustration I'm talking about. I don't want somebody's help. I want to do it on my own.
That's right.
This is completely different than anything I'd ever seen. Dan,
and
I want to bring it over
here. That's
not all
we did. We did not leave any stone unturned with this. Basically, the cane also does a second thing that which challenges it. It takes away a hand, right? So now you're down to one hand. So we've created a reversible hook. So this hook will give you that extra hand
that's
that
really
you need.
Good.
So now I can carry my groceries. You see that? Sturdy, it will hold 17 pounds. That is a, and if you decide that, hey, you know what? I'm now gonna take a break, I'm gonna sit down, let's reverse the hook.
It goes over the back of the chair.
It goes over the back of the hand, so you don't have to worry about picking it up.
Because my problem is, I would put this darn thing up against the chair and knock it over, and the cane itself was the first thing I would have to try to bend down and pick up. Do me a favor, throw something on the floor. Give me anything.
Absolutely.
Throw a sock down there.
A sock, you know, a big problem. You drop your sock.
Here's the button on the side. And all you do is you release your grip here and you push with your finger. And what it does is it will pop out this wonderful little barrier right here. And that becomes your squeeze. And that's the trigger for this wonderful little gripper at the bottom. So I had it on the floor so the camera could pick it up. All you do is pick it up, pop it, and then where's my sock?
Your socks right
Throw
here.
Throw me a sock.
Throw you a sock.
Okay.
So we went to the VA. We visited the VA because you know what? I wanted to give it out. I wanted to give feedback. And we've taken
that's
all that
so
feedback
good.
And we've realized that that's the biggest fear that people have that use a cane. If you know somebody that uses a cane, their biggest fear if you talk to them is that I'm falling, and that's why you use a cane in the first place, is for stability. I mean, this is not only sturdy, it's beautiful, but it's going to give you that extra hand that you need.
This thing holds 150 to 200 pounds of pressure. Now, if you're a 200-pound man, when you walk with a walking stick, you're not putting 200 pounds of pressure on it. you're putting considerably less than that. So this is your lifeline. This is your sense of independence. There are three colors. We've got basic black, we've got silver, we've got a really pretty anodized purple. And at $39.92, it does what no other cane I've ever seen can do. I had my little grabber that would be next to my chair.
That's right.
Because getting up and down was excruciating for me at the time. She just picked up a pill off the floor. Her eyeglasses off the floor.
All very common, simple little things that you don't consider if you don't use a cane.
Exactly right.
But are absolutely excruciating if you do.
Yeah, it's, I was going to say, pick up something heavier.
It's a strong cane. If you get a rock in your shoe.
We were talking about that. It made me nuts because I would get a rock in my shoe and I couldn't get it with my cane. So now I can actually grip something nice and heavy and be able to pick it up. And be able to get it.
Yeah. These are really, look at that.
Look at that.
I mean, now
it's
you're not
really good,
it's,
buddy.
It's really pretty neat. And you know what? If you're getting ready in the morning and you drop your bracelet, this is an easy way for fixture. But you know what? Nobody even knows that you're carrying this. That's the cool thing. People are going to be so shocked.
Exactly.
You're walking around. We put a nice, soft, gentle handle here.
And you see the handle better on the silver because on the it's done in blue. But that's a padded handle. There's your mechanism, which is located right here for the gripper. We've got it on Easy Pay. This is all done in wonderful, lightweight aircraft aluminum. There's a reversible hook, which is adjustable.
Reversible.
And we've got purple, and then we've also got the black.
That's right, two different sizes. So 36 inches, standard cane, 33 inches if you're under 5'4".
First time that Rachel and I have had an opportunity to present these, I'm telling you, brilliant idea, my friend.
Thank you, sir.
You're going to help a lot of people.
Yeah.
Congratulations on that. It's called a snapper cane, the walking cane with the grasping extender, $39.92. Thanks, Dan.
Thank you, sir.